never bothered me anyway. Idina Menzel. Still frozen in the height of summer. What can you do? And it's time for us to let it go, because that is it for EPOS this afternoon. Johnny Walker can't hold it back anymore. He's up next with Sounds of the 70s. And I'll rise like the break of dawn next Sunday with lots more show tunes. Oh, and let the storm rage on, because I'm also back this evening hosting Radio 2's coverage of Cynthia Erivo's Legendary Voices Prom. And that's on Sunday night, is Music Night, tonight at 8. See you then. I'm Elaine Page, and this is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 3 o'clock. This is Adam Porter. People wishing to cross the Channel are enduring a third day of disruption. The AA says drivers still face lengthy delays heading to the Eurotunnel terminal at Folkestone. However, the situation at Dover has eased. Dan Johnson reports.
The number of lorries backed up on the M20 motorway has meant cars heading for Folkestone's Eurotunnel terminal being diverted onto roads that can't cope with the level of traffic, leading to more long delays for drivers trying to get across the Channel. Some spent the night in their cars and waited as long as 21 hours to board a train. Authorities say they've been working around the clock to clear the backlog that built up from Friday morning, but there are renewed calls for the government to provide more space to get trucks off the roads when there's disruption like this.
Russia has admitted it carried out an attack on the Ukrainian port city of Odessa yesterday, saying it used high-precision missiles to target military equipment. Ukraine said the strike showed Moscow could not be trusted to implement the deal it agreed to unblock grain exports. James Waterhouse is in Odessa.
There was footage yesterday which the BBC has verified, which showed a burning ship. Now, all the signs showed that it didn't look outwardly, at least, like a military target, but of course it's very hard to establish that completely. And so it's not clear why Moscow has done this other than to simply flex its muscles, to tell Ukraine, look, nowhere in your country is safe or out of range from our long-range missiles.
A state of emergency has been declared in part of California as a huge wildfire spreads rapidly near Yosemite National Park. The blaze has grown quickly since Friday, and firefighters have struggled to get it under control. More than 6,000 people have been told to leave the area. Pope Francis is on his way to Canada, where he'll repeat a formal apology to Indigenous survivors of abuse inflicted at Roman Catholic-run schools. Unmarked graves were discovered last year at some sites, where children were subjected to neglect, isolation and malnutrition as part of a policy of cultural assimilation. Leah Redcrow, from a group representing the interests of survivors of residential schools and their descendants, says church documents from the past should be made available to show more facts about what happened.
Open up the secret archive so we can go and get those daily journals. And I think that will help more with reconciliation than him saying sorry. You know, like, that would be affirmative action to say, look, you know, an apology, like, who, it doesn't really mean anything to me. What I want is affirmative action for them to open up the archives and let our researchers go in there.
The Board of Scottish Cricket's governing body has resigned the day before the publication of a review which looked at racism in the sport. The report's expected to find that institutional racism exists within cricket in the country. The directors of Cricket Scotland have apologised to all victims of discrimination. BBC News, it's 3 minutes past three. BBC Radio 2. Now let's get some travel news. Here's Orna.
Adam, thank you. And Glasgow queues on the M8. They're between 22 at the M77 and 20 at the M74. It's only a breakdown, though. It's looking busier on the M8 just near the roadside or the Woodside Viaduct roadworks. Now, 5 to Edinburgh and the M90. Still slightly slow, heading over the bridge there, so it might slow down the Queensferry crossing. Stockton on Tees, the A19 is closed in both directions between Wolverston and the Norton interchange. And in Cheshire, the M6 Thirlwall Viaduct, junction 20 to 21. All traffic was held back. Two lanes are still closed there, and the queues are backing up to 19 at Knutsford. That's after an accident. It's taking about 50 minutes. Leeds and the A643 northbound approaching the A58 is looking slow. The M25 is all open now at 26 at Waltham Abbey, but it's still looking quite slow through Surrey around junction 8 on the clockwise side, and heading around junction 15 near the M4 looking slow clockwise as well. And also just to warn you as well that we've still got the big problems heading towards both Folkestone and Dover. The M20 is closed on the coastbound side, junction 8 at Leeds Castle to 12 at Cheriton, so that's to all traffic. All other traffic has to use the A20, but it's total gridlock trying to get into your Euro Tunnel, but also some of those surrounding routes, so the A259, also the A261 London Road near the one-way system, are also affected. More in an hour.
What we're going to do right here is go back, way back, back into time. These days are all.
Sky. Please tell us why you